Hi everyone, my name is Laura Holly and this is Pedagogo Reviews, reviewing albums and EPs from popular, old school, lesser known and independent artists. I have a moustache in support of Movember. Do click on the link that I put in the description box below, which takes you to the official website where you can look at other tashes, make a donation, upload your own pictures, just support the great cause to help raise awareness for male health. Today requires a bit of preparation, so let me just get into my imaginary human-sized condom so that I don't impregnate you all whilst I talk about Kaleidoscope Dream, the second album from R&B singer-songwriter Miguel, which was released on the 25th of September through RCA Records. I came across Miguel a couple of months ago when I saw his video for the first single from the album, Adorn. Now what I like most about this song is the way he does a little every now and again, just randomly. I think it's pretty cool. Then I watched the video for the second single, Do You, which caught me by surprise. A very lovely surprise. As it started, I thought it was going to be some hippie-ish, mellow, psychedelic R&B thing. But before I knew it, I was 1 minute in, and this nice little beat started, and then out of nowhere, this amazing beat dropped, and I was like, nice. So after that, I went and bought the album, and this is certainly an album that's more about taking time to let it sink in instead of immediately catch your repetitive phrases. It sounds like Miguel has taken the influence of soul from the 60s right up to the 90s and just injected it all with modern day technology. And the reason I mentioned impregnating you all earlier is because this is a baby-making album. You put this album on and you know it's time to get down to business, which is why I listen to it alone. But no, Miguel has a sensual voice and he uses it with balance, making sure he only shows you his falsetto and those strong power notes at times when they're really needed. His voice is controlled, it's soft, and it feels more raw than a lot of contemporary male R&B artists. And the lyrics follow suit. They're not the hardest to understand. You know what he's singing about, sex and love most of the time, but the topics are addressed delicately, passionately, emotionally, so that you feel the experience. But it's not all sex and love. Tracks Where's the Fun in Forever and Candles in the Sun get all deep and serious, showing us that Miguel is not only a sex machine, but also an intelligent and philosophical thinker. There's Promiscuous track, How Many Drinks, a nice little banger for them players out there scouting the club for a shawty to take back to their crib and do that thing too. And this isn't a cocky song, it's a slick, confident approach with a predominant bassline, soft keys, and three-part harmonies playing wingman to Miguel's smooth chat. The only song I really don't like on this album is Pussy Is Mine. There are a few reasons why I don't like it. Firstly, I don't like the word pussy. It just makes me cringe a bit. I know, how very prude of me. Secondly, it's not tuneful. I know I said at the beginning that this isn't a catchy album, but when there's just a guitar and a vocal, I would like there to be something more memorable other than the line, tell me that that pussy is mine. Thirdly, it just feels like a filler track, and it's the only song on the album that I want to skip when it comes on. I think it'll be good as a live performance, and in fact, I watched a video of Miguel performing this, and the ladies were going crazy for it, of course, but as an album track, I don't think it's needed, I think it's just a bit filler. But speaking of fillers, I'm going to fill out this video by suggesting various scenarios where it would be suitable, almost, to play this album. You're in a long-term relationship and you want to do something special slash reignite the flame with your other half. Set the mood, dinner, candles, flowers, this album. You're in a new relationship and that first time is approaching. Set the mood, dinner, candles, flower petals, and this album. You want to be in a relationship with one of your close friends. Invite them over, get them drunk, put this album on. You want sexy time with a close friend. Invite them over, get them drunk, put this album on. You want your close friend to reciprocate the feelings that you have towards them. Invite them for a sleepover and put this album on very quietly before you go to sleep. Or you can wait till they go to sleep and then just put the album on quietly. You brought someone home and need some confidence before sexy time, some backup. Whack this on, let Miguel do the work. You've lost your 50 Shades of Grey and need to fill the sexy void. You're reading 50 Shades of Grey and need a soundtrack. Your internet is down and you have no access to porn. You feel like having some me time. Yes, me time. You just want to listen to some music. So as I've pretty much said throughout this whole review, Kaleidoscope Dream is a sexy album, and Miguel does it well. There are a lot of artists that brag about their sex swag, but with Miguel it's quite believable. Maybe it's because he doesn't brag but talks about sex and love in a way that's sexually inspiring, or in a way that makes you think of a time that makes you smile. Nice. And he has the music to back him up. It's never overpowering, never over-modernized enough to push aside the influence of Motown and soul, and it's a great mix of real instruments, synths, and 808 beats. For these reasons, I give Kaleidoscope Dream a 4 out of 5. There is about 10% of it that I personally could do without, but otherwise it is marvellous. Miguel is currently touring the US and will be visiting Europe over January, February next year. So, as always, I've put the link to his official website in the description box below where you can check out dates, venues, costs, and any news. And if you want to watch Miguel in motion, I've posted the link to his official Vivo channel on YouTube in the description box below. Thanks for watching, everyone. On Monday, I will be reviewing Trilogy, a compilation album from hyped R&B artist The Weeknd. So do tune in. But until then, have a wonderful weekend, ho ho ho, and I will see you on Monday. You wanna be high for this.